Finally tonight, the podcast rises again. Business is booming as technology has made it easier to listen. And one program in particular has turned into an unexpected phenomenon in recent weeks. Hari Sreenivasan gets the lowdown on the big surge in downloads.
For the last year, I've spent every working day trying to figure out where a high school kid was for an hour after school one day in 1999.
That's just part of the hook of a weekly podcast called Serial that's riveted millions and spawned fan clubs with its exploration of a true murder case and a felon's potential innocence.
It's Serial, one story told week by week. I'm Sarah Koenig.
First released in October, Serial is a spin-off of the public radio program This American Life. Each week, the program's investigation of the case seems to unfold along with the listener. The focus? The 1999 conviction of a high school senior named Adnan Syed, who was charged with the murder of his ex-girlfriend, Haemin Lee. Serial host and creator Sarah Koenig takes listeners through an extensive re-examination of the alibis, testimony, work of the defense attorney done back then, asking whether Syed really was guilty. It's a huge hit in the world of podcasting, garnering 5 million downloads on iTunes, far more than any other podcast in history. But the idea of a serial is as old as Charles Dickens, who experienced wild success with the Pickwick Papers in the mid-1800s.
This is a spark cast for the week of May 12th.
The notion of podcasting stories has gained steam in recent years, with popular ones such as This American Life, which has about a million downloads a week, and Planet Money. Less well-known ones draw smaller audiences, but still have substantial followings. In fact, last year, Apple reported that subscriptions to podcasts through iTunes reached 1 billion. Raw Voice, which tracks 20,000 shows, said the number of unique monthly podcast listeners has tripled to 75 million from 25 million just 5 years ago.
We've only scratched the surface of the obsession some have with Serial. It's inspired fan clubs, academic and legal inquiries, blogs, and yes, more podcasts about the podcast. David Haglund is a senior editor at Slate who edits its culture blog and is a regular panelist on Slate's podcast about Serial. So now we are having a TV conversation with a man who has a podcast about a podcast. So why is there this fascination with just one story?
Well, the story itself is gripping, obviously. You know, anytime a murder goes not unsolved, but raises questions about who actually did it, you know, people get interested. You get interested right away. The fact that it was a young woman supposedly killed by an ex-boyfriend. I mean, there are sensational details that grip you. But then on top of that, podcasting is a very intimate form. And the producers of Serial and its host, Sarah Koenig, are masters at it. And when you listen to them, you feel like you're listening to a friend talk to you in great detail about the case. And that's just gripping. That brings it to you in a way that a TV show or a book might not.
When you said intimacy, it made me think of the fact that a lot of us are now consuming audio here, not even in the big room, right? I mean, or perhaps in the car, which is also a semi-intimate space. You're by yourself. Does that play into why podcasting seems to be making a little bit of a comeback?
It definitely does. I mean, for me, I listen on my commute into Manhattan on the subway. So I've got my headphones in, and I see other people with their headphones in. And with Serial in particular, given its popularity, I'm sure some of them are listening to the same thing I am. But we're each having our own solitary experience sort of communing with the story.
And I said comeback, I shouldn't have. I mean, podcasting's been around for quite some time. What is it that has recently made it more popular? I mean, Apple said something about, what, a billion downloads of podcasts?
Well, it's getting easier and easier to download them. There are more apps. You know, just about everybody has a smartphone now, so you can get a podcast very easily. On top of that, it's becoming easier and easier to listen to podcasts in your car. And I think that's the next, you know, big wave. I think not only are podcasts growing in popularity now, but there's a huge surge in the near future, I would say.
So they're replacing commercial radio as we know it in the car, especially for those people who are commuting every morning or every evening?
For a lot of people. I mean, I wouldn't want to overstate it yet. You know, more people listen to terrestrial radio, certainly, and podcasting remains to some degree a niche form, but I think that's about to change.
So what kind of podcasts are more successful than others if you had to look across the entire spectrum?
Well, lately, podcasts like Serial, real, you know, intensely produced story podcasts are becoming more and more popular. Prior to that, comedy podcasts were huge. And I think the reason they hit first is because podcasting is a very loose form. It doesn't have to abide by time limits in the way that most radio shows do. And so you can kind of let yourself go. And a lot of panel shows are very popular as well for similar reasons. You can talk and talk, you know, as far as the conversation takes you and then stop. And because it feels so intimate, the people who are listening feel like they're part of the conversation.
Yeah, speaking of the part of the conversation, especially around Serial, there's lots and lots of conversations in different online forums, conspiracy theories galore. Everyone has a theory about, well, who did it, or was there misconduct by this person or that person? Well, why do we get so into this narrative in almost like an interactive fashion?
Well, I think nowadays when you can go online and go to a place like Reddit, for instance, and commune with other people who are discussing the case, you start to feel as though you'll get to the bottom of it. And a lot of the documents related to the case are also available online. So you can actually pore over the very things that the producers themselves are looking at, not all of them, but enough of them to make you think, you know, maybe if I look some more, I'll finally find the clue that they've missed.
Okay, is this leading to people discovering other podcasts?
I think it is. Yeah, I mean, I was home for Thanksgiving recently, and my younger brother told me he had just listened to a podcast for the first time, and of course it was Serial. And now that he's listened, you know, to that one, maybe he'll download another one, maybe he'll get into the habit. I think that's happening for a lot of people.
All right, David Haglund, senior editor at Slate, thanks so much.
Thanks for having me.